How do you find Star Citizen?
It is actually not that bad. Not that I figured out how to buy the fucking cutlass. Like, it's as of right now, like the gimp, they're fixing like the cutlass, right? Like they're doing like every month they rehaul a ship and all that shit, like fix its issues and they release it. Like it's been the because this next patch is gonna be the cutlass and all that shit. They're releasing the its fixes on that shit. But same time though, I figured out how to unfuck it too. Basically, you have to put on fixed weapons,
It's
all that
actually
shit.
not
But
that
same time,
bad.
it's
I
not
figured
that
out how
bad
to
because if you're using the mouse, it's
buy the
basically
cutlass.
fucking
Like it's
same thing as using Gibbold and all that shit. So it's my preferentially.
I see.
And you get the benefit of fucking heavy weapons. At the same time, you need to make your ship. We need to make the cutlass flow upwards. Move upwards just a little bit, the tiniest bit. And make sure your target's below your line of, below the line of horizon for you. So you have to, make sure you're either rolling and like you're rolling or like when you're rolling into them, like your top side is towards them at all times as you're like as you're rolling or as you're pitching into them, all that crap. You know what I'm saying?
Yep. I don't know, I'm still not like convinced to try it, though. I think I owe it to Draki to try it out.
It's the free things. Are you over?
Oh, well, okay, that makes it easier.
Maybe next time.
Yeah. I mean, it's. I don't have much time lately, so.
It's the
Yeah.
same exact time. They've been taking their sweet ass time. Like their launch date got pushed back, I guess, from what Draki's saying. And I'm a little loopy teeth. I'm a little pissed.
They started out with a very overambitious project, let's be honest here.
Yeah.
Oh well, I should say their Squadron 42 should have been launched this year, and they're freaking the fuck's this? The fucking the their multiplayer mode that's supposed to be launching next year. So they said.
Well, we'll see. I mean, I have Elite and haven't played it much.
Nobody's on no more. Like they're
If you want a small gunboat with absolutely no really chance of coming back, here you go.
Yeah, the Rust one. We tried this one, actually, and it was really fun. It's one of those in which you have to like time and it's kind of like a one pass deal.
You can do okay if you're with these, but by themselves, not so much.
I found a funny little glitch in Star Citizen.
What'd you find?
The cutlass comes with the it comes standard with these missiles called rattlers, right? Basically, it's a missile. Then it's like the main missile is the mothership and shit, basically, and it launches multiple little missiles.
Okay, so it's got more warheads on it
Yeah, basically, and the main missile is is an EMP blast in a sense.
then.
It takes out ships in a radius, and the little ones go to work on them, on the other ships. But same time though, like if there's friendly ships in the vicinity of it, the little missiles might target onto the your friendlies and swarm them and kill them.
So it's a very situational weapon. You got to make sure your allies are clear.
Yeah,
I mean,
and
I
half the
don't.
time.
I mean, that adds an interesting mechanic.
And I've also been taken out by my own missile too. It's hilarious.
Get out by your own weapon.
I watched it too arc right into my cockpit. I was like, oh crap, bam. Like you see in the corner of your eyes, like that better not hit me, and then it hits you. It's like, god damn it.
Yeah, I don't even wanna like try to do a test with these gunboats. Well, we could do. is, you know, I guess maybe as an appetizer for when we eventually do the whole gunboat, rodeo, whatever. Would you like to try them against that frigate over there, the IMDC frigate?
Good when time comes.
Would you like to try one now? Yeah.
Good.
I mean, just to
try the Kestrel out against it. Anyways, that ship I'm familiar with. The other two I haven't flown much, so.
I mean, it's a static target. It's basically just to gauge the whole sim speed drop.
Yay. What's really cool about that rail snake, though, as well, like, it,
jerkiness, though, jeez.
It doesn't really destroy the ships. It leaves them intact as well. Like, it if those little missiles hit, it'll destroy a piece of the ship.
Here, my weapons are targeting.
Whoa. Oh, that's fine.
Yeah, I walked right into that. that didn't go too well.
Oop. That was fun, though.
I walked right into that because I was trying not to shoot my own stuff, and then I ended up getting shot by that.
That's fine. Let's redo the test. Let me remove the other ones.
Yeah, hurt me.
Oh, that reminds me. I have enough to buy that fucking shit now.
Remove this.
Knock on NBC, or is that...
Okay, you can teleport back. And let's try again.
Oh yeah, the stock one, okay. I haven't seen a stock IMDC frigate in so long. Okay, we'll try the Kestrel out one more time. Biggest mistake we ever did in this thing is we didn't put a camera on it.
Okay, oh, hey, that's loud.
Whoa, yeah. Wait, you're still within? Oh.
Yeah, I was above range of the damn ship.
Are we that close? For safety measure, come back to Calypso, mm-hmm. And then we'll be in from there.
Just need to get 1K out. Okay, I'm 1K away from there now. I should be better.
Okay.
You can still hit me out here. Wow, I think that's some range.
And the turret, and as of right now, there's a piece for the Cutlass. It turns your turret into a gimbaled turret, but... The entire component layout is not available as of right now.
Hmm.
Sucks.
Here we go.
Makes me a sad panda. Oh, hey! There's a lot.
Oh.
You should come here as Laser and try your nukes.
I'm using it.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Yeah, I was supposed to impact the target.
So I guess you took out one of the nacelles and...
This thing was designed as a prototype, so it only got limited combat use, but...
Give me a second, be right back.
Well, my missile run did some damage to it, but... Back did more. probably look at the design again and see if I can upgrade the Hyperion once more.
Okay, I'm back.
If I recall correctly, when we used the Kestrel, we'd send in our corvettes or destroyers first to soak up the fire, then the Kestrels would swoop in and just rain death down on targets.
Makes sense.
We only used it in about 3 or 4 battles we ever fought in. I'd say testing was a little inconclusive on that, but if it was effective or not, but and it moved, it could, fighters didn't touch it. It'd have been better if I would have made the grav drive go sideways instead of forwards.
Yeah, actually, like make the whole orbiting thing.
Yeah, that would have been better than forward and reverse. I'll have to actually go back to the design and see how hard it would be to retrofit it that way.
Really like this one.
The problem with that ship is it's got no Gatling weapons on it except for the aft section.
Please no, this is not Gatling cannon. Yeah, no shit. Play this later. I'm joining you guys. I got on Daisy earlier, I got a fucking shot in the back. Shotgun.
Always
5 minutes. Turn the corner, but I was like, what the fuck? I was like, I'm pretty sure this server said no killing on site. Alright. Mm-hmm. But then again, I don't know why I'm bitching, because I do that shit all the time.
Yeah, it's your karma.
When I domed that guy in the head the other night.
One thing I don't understand here in the clip, so why use the standard doors? Why not just use the airlock ones? Passing between compartments easier.
Especially my stubbornness of keeping the bulkhead doors as, you know, the classic ones and only the airlock ones for the.
I can see for maintenance doors, but for internal ship, I'd do the airlock ones. Just that way, you can pressurize between the compartments. If anymore, I use double doors between compartments. That way, if one section gets depressurized, I can still go between them. But
yeah, no, I hear you. It's just that, you know, like I said, it's more like a design choice.
It's a cram full of stuff. This thing's got the. Not only refinery capability, it's also combat capable.
Oh, this thing is sick.
Well thought out, all the gyros are built off the center line. I like that.
Oh, you're in the engineering section?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is kind of like a never-ending, ongoing process for me.
Building up ready.
Mm-hmm. Clip.
And recently, the latest change that I did was to move the gyros around. I had a bunch of them attached to the jump drive, and those are really susceptible to just like being, you know, single shotted by any kind of collision. So,
and I noticed, like, I know Seth, he does the armor blocks with a deformation won't damage. That's something I'm gonna have to look into, because
definitely. So it turns out that the jump drive, it has high hit points, but it's basically a single hit for any kind of collision, even a tiny, a small grid block. So you are better off dividing the mounting points for the gyros in on weaker blocks, just because you're not putting your eggs in one basket.
Any more gyros, I've started to actually start to put them on the outside of the ship a little bit. That way if they get shot or damaged, they break off. Or close to the outside of the ship. That way they'll be like the first thing to go before any of the core systems.
Yeah, exactly.
Let me know if you want me to hit it.
Yeah, so that'll be a good test. Let's do a copy of this one, and then high ground, if you want to try out, let's say the damage resistant properties of any of your designs. We have Slacer throw one of his suicide nukes at it.
This is not like that, though. Holy shit. I'm making jerky again.
Oh, yeah. This time you said that you were actually adding the sugar, right?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh. Man, crash.
Let's
get the fuck out of me.
Yeah.
At this step, I cut it up in little strips. It's like, I think you got another hour and a half before it's done.
How do you do that?
Put the oven on like on 170.
Uh-huh.
I leave it open. I leave the oven door open. I put it in the middle. I have a little fan blowing air into it.
I see.
So like, you know, all, so there's no, like, no moisture in there. It's all evaporating out, drying out as fast as it can. But it's not so hot where it's actually baking the meat. It's actually drying it out.
Got
and
it.
Then I'm also using a salt method, fucking osmosis and mass.
How much? I mean, what meat do you buy, and what's the yield?
Top round.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking just I think it was a pound, or not a pound. Like 0.75 a pound ish. It wasn't a full pound, it was like just under. It's like 80.8 fucking when or
oh damn.
4/5 is a pound, goddamn. There we go. And it's already lean, it's pretty lean already. And I stick in a bunch of soy sauce, a little bit of Worcestershire sauce, and fucking I put sea salt.
Oh,
and
nice.
seasoning salt and all that in there as well. So freaking make it really salty, and stick it in the well, and some you know, spices and all that. This batch is gonna be spicy as shit. The peppers, or I put fucking dried peppers in there.
Yeah, it'll be too much for me.
That'll do it.
Okay, you guys can join again.
Like my shit spicy.
Literally.
Last time I made the like the pieces were too thick, so it was like still, I was like, I baked, like it was a half jerky and half baked meat, like roasted meat. Like it was actually not that bad. It was like really, really fucking good. And sometimes I think you like tear into it and you'll find salt crystals in between the meat, like in between the meat fibers.
see if I can find one of those old designs I had. It was like one of the first PVV designs ever. It was from the UESC. It was like a really cheap gunship. I mean, it was like a joke by today's standards. But.
Well, let's check it out.
I don't have it on me. I got lost it in the thing. I was trying to find the picture of it to rebuild it.
Oh, that's fine.
I mean, it was just like, didn't even have rocket launchers on it. It was just all Gatling guns.
Hey, you want to copy my nuke? So more people will fiddle with it, come up with better designs and all that shit.
Yeah. Should let me remove all of the other grids just to...
Hyperion?
No, I mean, leave that and we're going to use it as a test target.
We're using the Hyperion?
Yeah, that can make a nice test.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hey, who's shooting at me?
High ground?
Not shooting anybody. You're not in the fact. Oh, you're getting shot by the medical center.
Oh, can you join the faction, Slicer?
Well, the guns on that should be off. Outside the welcome center shoot now, it might be the Hyperion. I mean, how's that for a welcome center? You're only about 50 or 60 meters from death.
Yeah.
Yeah, welcome get shot instantly.
I got exposed. What the fuck?
Oh. Apply to the faction, and I will save.
Mm-hmm. Next time you hop on here, you don't have to worry about not being in a faction.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Passing in the nuke.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's the one with the pistons.
Mm-hmm. Let me make sure they're piston locked.
We make a copy of it.
Here we go. Whoa, hey. That's scary.
The sardine, yeah. I'm gonna blueprint it and then remove the copy. Mm-hmm.
It's mod 3/1_1.
Okay, got it. So, high ground, this is Slicer's trolling weapon.
It already uses weapons of mass derpiness pistons. Badly they operate lately, I'm not even sure it'll work. But.
You want to make a save of it? Or a copy of it?
I got a copy of it.
Can we use it on that Hyperion?
Yes.
Let's see how it holds up.
The only problem with it is when, you know, with it having pistons and all, it's really, really, really horrible at turning, so you have to... You have to hope that you're on point with your aiming and all that.
Otherwise, you're up Shit's Creek.
Yeah. Another variant that had, whatchamacallit, freaking, a delayed or... Oh, hey! Whoa, shit!
Well,
it's
pre-detonation. Yeah,
it's the missiles.
Yeah, wow.
I came in at a bad angle too. So,
launches are going and doing work.
Oh, I'm gonna miss because the pistons are throwing me around.
Hey, where are you? Oh, I see. Well, I think what we need, just to trade. Yeah. I mean, to try the destructive power, we should have a target that doesn't fire back, see like the potential, and then try it. Try to find ways of actually hitting. Oh, there you
Going
go.
in.
Whoa,
I missed too.
Yeah, I mean,
Missed.
kind of missed, but
Yeah, you blew a hole right in main engineering.
yeah, and took out the bridge, the nut bridge.
Main cockpit is operational.
Oh yeah.
Rear cockpit destroyed, so your battle bridge is gone. Here, let me put up a new target for you.
Hold up. Actually, yeah, cut, fuck it.
I'll pull up one of my Hyperions. It's a little better armored. It'll give you a run for your money.
Dude, I bounced right off of it too, and then like then it's crazy part, like the cockpit survived, everything else freaking behind it got destroyed.
Right. This is not the upgraded one, this is just the standard one. Here, I'll put it in battle mode.
The Hyperion is still one of my favorite designs by JD. Somehow I like it better than some of his new frigates.
Pirates, here we go, space pirates. Yeah, this one will give you a lot more trouble. Got interior turrets for point defense on board.
Oh yeah, I see them firing.
And this isn't even a fully upgraded one either. Only the partially upgraded one.
Holy shit, dude, I'm trying to slow down. These pistons are throwing me around.
Yeah, I've... In regular by yourself, they're fine, but in multiplayer, oh my god.
Let me do some trash removal.
This is gonna. Am I going fast? I don't know. 40? Yeah, looks like.
Oh. There he goes. Oh!
Ooh, shit!
Yeah, I got pre detonated. That's really impressive, like how the explosion looks. I wonder if there's a way of, like, if you place some decoy block on the front.
You know, right now decoys aren't working in the stable branch, but in the development branch they are. In the future,
yeah,
they'll work.
But I mean, like, any kind of, like, you know, quote unquote decoy block, something that would attract fire, or maybe let's fire them in tandem. At a distance that, you know, that if the first one pre-detonates, it wouldn't catch the follow-up.
It is. Here it is. I found that original PvP design. I just got to rebuild it. Well, the point defense system works. Here, let me spawn in a new Hyperion. I'll make sure the point defense system's up.
You know, I think this being a static target, the weak approach is the stern.
Yeah, here I'll spawn. Let me get the workshop version of it.
Okay.
I don't have the regular one for some reason. Get a ways out here so I don't shoot at anything.
And pistons are still trash.
Yeah, they need to just make it where it's part. It acts like it's part of the grid, not the up and down bullshit. Mm-hmm. Okay. Where's the blueprints? But yeah. I need to rebuild this Hyperion, but
yeah.
Just a second. Yeah, well, in a minute. I guess, sorry, I had someone yelling at me.
Okay.
Where did the Hyperion go? There it is. God, I'm not using push to talk. I gotta be careful. Okay, I will make sure the interior turrets don't target any players.
We know when to come in.
Oh, this one has, wow, a top-mounted, receded missile turret.
Yeah, this one's a lot better armed.
Nice. Well, I like this turret arrangement. Yeah, it has way much better coverage. Yeah, way better. Is this the one from the workshop, or you, or one of your blueprints?
This is one of my blueprints from the workshop since that lousy original.
We hit.
Oh, so this one is in workshop.
It is on the workshop, yeah.
Okay.
Coming in.
Go ahead. Let it happen. It will not shoot at players or large ships, so. Yeah, this version's got 4 extra Gatling guns plus 2 extra turrets or missile turrets.
Dude, it launched me backwards. What the fuck is this?
Ejection seat?
Can fix your shit. It's doing that shit for the what Draki fucking got the other day or the other last week.
No, I haven't seen it. Whoa.
Hey. If that wasn't gonna blow attack. That was being defenseless.
But you want it defenseless?
Yeah. That's what the plan was.
Okay, I'm gonna spawn a new one then.
Yeah, let's do one static no defenses to measure the damage potential. So I guess that's one thing with the quote unquote nukes, the cluster munitions, is that they need to come in clean, like without any kind of interception, otherwise it's just pre-detonate.
Or you need noise or someone flying that. Okay, here it is.
And does not help too that these freaking pistons are so glitchy, like it's tossing the ship around by itself.
Mm-hmm. All right, weapons are off. Fire when ready.
They get some distance.
The pistons are for penetration, right?
Yeah. I mean, they could have fixed the issue and all that shit. Or not the issue, but they could have fixed that since I last tested it. I don't know.
Firing rate weapons vary from week to week.
Hmm. Nothing's ever consistent in this fucking game.
Where are you coming from, Slicer?
It looks like the top.
Okay.
Like my ship's not slowing down because the fucking pistons. Okay, coming in now.
Okay.
1.3 clicks out.
You should put a beacon on that because I'm.
Yeah.
I mean, don't do it now. That's fine.
I'm coming in.
Well, that looked impressive.
Okay. Pistons are still there. It blew a hole straight through the bottom of the ship. Took out a good chunk of main engineering. Took out the entire command and control apparatus. And almost the entire control command and control apparatus. I still have 2 jump seats forward.
Mm-hmm.
I've got 2 medical bays still operational, but you've ripped the ship a new one. Let me see how badly damaged she is in terms of maneuverability. Oh, she could still fight, but she'd be very crippled. Let's see, you took out 1 Gatling gun up top, took out some of the thrusters. Yeah, this would render her really... She couldn't run away now, but... Now, if you hit it in the front section, right between the 2 missile launchers, you will probably break the ship in half.
Yeah.
But you hit it right where you want to hit it for terms of damage potential. Oh, that was more devastating than I thought it'd be. Didn't think it'd go all the way through like then. Here, I'll spawn in a fresh. yeah, you would have been better off hitting the section a little bit behind it because that was a thicker section. It's still held together by a couple blocks. Basically, two blocks are all the only thing holding this thing together.
I have a theory about this thing. If you know, the explosions are fixed, you know, happenings in space. So if your ship is moving, and let's say you is moving in this vector, and you hit it with the same vector, different direction, up in the nose, is the ship going to run through all of the explosions and be completely destroyed?
Would you like to try one moving at like 20 meters a second?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We'll do that linearly. Yeah.
I try to hit it from the front side too. I have the most, or not the front, but I hit it in a front glancing angle. You know what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm.
Body. See if that freaking does anything.
Yeah, I mean, let's try. So, high ground, he will be flying. You will be flying it? Or you just want to set it to, okay.
I'll fly it. I'll get it going at 20 meters a second and put the dampeners off.
Okay. And Slicer, you will hit it like on the same vector, right on the nose, and see how the explosions, like, I mean, what happens. So if you can maximize the damage of each explosion by, you know, like moving blocks through it.
Mm-hmm. I'm taking off one of the pistons.
Okay.
I'll get her up this here real quick. Lag, I don't know how well it's going to work because it's going to want to keep going.
Maybe that will help, actually. The whole sim speed drop and all that will help. Unless it slows you down. So I guess you're going to have to like keep, you know, tapping.
I'm just going between 14 and 20 right now. It's just bouncing around. I'm going to keep at the speed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Didn't King said that they're going to fix the random popping off of the piston heads?
Yeah, the problem is now the piston wants to spaz out and destroy your ship.
Mm-hmm.
And that's in the dev branch only, so they might fix it. Okay, ready for firing whenever.
I'm moving ahead of you. Okay, I'm getting in position.
Get at least like 1 kilometer so you can do course correction and then come in.
Okay, I see him way out there. He's 2 kilometers out.
Mm-hmm. Think you're going in too high.
Thing.
Coming in.
Alright. Your best bet if you want to blow the ship in half is you want to hit between 2 of the launchers on the side.
You're coming at an angle, but yeah, let's see how it goes.
Ooh.
Huh. So it
much damage, but it was a lot more effective in damaging the ship.
Yeah. So it did kind of have that effect. Like the ship runs through the explosion and all the blocks get damaged.
If you had a ship that's covered in turrets, that will do the job. I mean,
mm-hmm.
I've got a partial damage to the conveyor system, so one side's gonna, the forward guns are gonna lose, well, no, the forward guns won't, I got it connected up in the front, so. But you took out, like, half the weapon armament on one side, so.
So let's try something now. Slicer, can you paste in, well, high ground, paste in a new one right here in this spot, and Slicer, you paste your nuke right next to it, align them perfectly, and move backwards.
Oh, wow. That was some speed just blowing me up. Holy shit. Oops. What was that about?
No idea. Yeah. Let's see. Well, that's how the game is behaving lately. Okay.
It actually gotten worse, but Ian started messing with it, but okay, we got a new copy in.
Okay, give me a second. I'll paste the sardine. Now it's not appearing. Great. Stupid blueprints. Okay, Slicer?
Yeah.
You see where the sardine is?
Mm-hmm.
So align it with the center and move backwards 1 kilometer and then I guess you have one. Okay. Let
from
me move
front?
The yeah. I mean let's try to make like an ideal scenario in which like the most of the length of the ship is gonna be affected. I mean just to get like
right
an
here.
Idea of like the absolute like the absolute most damage that you can get. Yes, that's great. Now, Slicer, move backwards, and, like, 1 kilometer, or whatever you need to get up to max speed,
mm-hmm.
and high ground, you will move forward at the same speed, between 14 and 20.
Here's hoping I don't blow up, or get launched, whatever.
Can you lock the pistons, just for the test?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they've been locked.
They still throw you around.
Yeah, when I had him on the fighter the other day, I had to pop the heads off just to get him to, you know.
Damn it.
Nah. Right, let me know when you want me to go up the throttle up. So.
Yes. Give me a second. Let me do some trash removal.
You see me?
Yep, you're at 1.34 kilometers.
I mean, I went in whenever I'm ready.
Okay, I'm trying to have to go back to the. Okay, 1 second. Okay, go.
Ooh, gang swing around.
That cruising.
Gonna hit. Yep. Gonna hit.
Oh my god.
The fuck?
Wow.
Get a little high, but
yeah.
You tear top of the ship off. You basically neutralize the entire point defense system up top. Took out the forward turret. Crippled the decoy system. And took out four of the six launchers. So yeah, you did a number.
Wow.
That's how the ship disappeared. I mean, there go decoys.
What's
go
the
go
other
get
thing?
Decoys.
Oh, this is a piece of the sardine.
Yeah, is there daylight down here when I get down the end of the door? End door. Yes, I now have a skylight.
Patio? A porch? Trim porch?
Yeah, right there. You totally took out all the conveyors for the main guns. You basically neutralized the lower turret because it's going to run out of ammunition now because there's no conveyor system connecting it. right, running right along the top part of that spine is the main conveyor system to the forward section. So you basically just, I might have my forward launchers here, might have some ammo left, but their combat effectiveness just died. So for the most part, I just lost the entire forward section of the ship. Yeah, my decoy is offline. I mean, wow. Now, if you would have hit a little lower, I think you would have taken out the entire front end, and you probably would have gotten, I don't know how far the penetration would have gone, but by looking at the explosive damage here, you probably would have gone straight, gotten through this whole front section, got past the gyros, and the rest of it would have detonated somewhere right here about midship, and it would have been devastating. You might have taken out all the weapon systems on the ship with a good hit. That's a scary ass weapon.
Funny good. Thing is, I actually made this in a public server, used it.
It's a good first strike weapon. If you can get the drop on me before I turn my guns on, guaranteed you're going to kill me.
It makes for a great audible little drop weapon on somebody's base.
Oh yeah.
Especially because they're not going to see it coming.
Yeah, I accidentally wiped out a base with the prototype.
What's it called, the weapon you got?
I just nicknamed it the Sardine.
Here it is. I want to take this thing apart and see what's in it.
It's the, look at the way that I have the explosive set up in sets of 500.
Okay, so you're saying you're using explosive stacking, right? Mm-hmm. What's on top of the explosives? Curious. Okay, you got a series of warheads setting off the explosives. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You know, instead of doing, there's something else you could try doing. Use missiles. Dead. Explosives.
That's actually not a bad idea.
Yeah.
We actually tried it where we used small warheads to break containers containing missiles, and then we used a gravity cannon to launch the missiles at a ship, and it actually ripped the enemy ship apart. Because you had stacks of like 10 or 20 missiles hitting, just doing massive damage. It was just insane.
The only problem with that in public service, those missiles have the chance of just despawning.
Yeah.
When they hit something.
We did have it work, though, occasionally on when we used it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it was just devastating that when it hit. It was just like, boom, gone. Where'd my ship go? I mean, it was fun watching at Hyperion, just all of a sudden it was down to, like, a few bricks. That was it.
But that was it that before the whole New King was nerfed?
No, this was after.
Wow.
Using missiles, they already got explosives built into them, so they already do damage. So. Man, I'm so...
I don't know. They detonated after...
I know. I didn't think they detonated impact either, but apparently they do. So.
That's weird, yeah, because I thought, like, after some update, like, King removed that. But then, I guess it was added back?
Oh, they might have. I don't know. I remember explosive stacking. I used to take a medium container, four thrusters, and just launch it at the ship. And when it hit, it exploded, and that was the end of whatever it did.
Yeah.
I did that with a large container once. I took out an entire asteroid. Except for the corner of it. There's just a little corner of their base hanging off the asteroid. It's like they were pissed.
It was really funny when like you have to like wait like for a few seconds. And then after that, like, you would see the aftermath. There was nothing there, or just, like, one piece of the ship.
I think I can make the Hyperion better by, Whoa!
I just tapped it.
I didn't do as much damage as going in, but still it...
Yeah. Yeah, I mean,
it's just...
I'd like to let you know the passenger seat and the bridge is still safe. I armor this up a lot more than JD had. I mean, this whole central core right here is like nothing but heavy armor, but now what I know about deformation, I'm probably going to change up a lot of it. But
yeah.
It'll be interesting to see what I come up with and how well it holds up. I had an antenna in the interior at one point, but I got rid of it. Like, why do I need an antenna?
I'm stuck.
Here. I'll get you out.
How do I get out now?
Here, I'll show you.
Yep. Oh, this.
Right here. You grab an assault rifle and you go. That didn't do as much damage as I thought it would.
No. No, warheads are like, meh.
It's like, what, 36 per large?
Large warhead should rip this thing apart. Or is it because I'm shooting it?
No, hear me out. It's because the armor is deformed. When heavy armor deforms, it becomes stronger for a reason, against explosions.
Seriously, then yes. I'm going to start using the deformed block to make deformed armor then, from mm-hmm. the start.
Yeah. I mean, it's not a bad idea. It's a really good defense against missiles. That's why you need like almost an infinite number of missiles to penetrate heavy armor after it's been hit one or twice.
That's why I say those 100mm ones are fucking insane mm-hmm. in the mod.
Yeah, from Raven Bolt's conveyor system that has like different calibers of missiles. It's one thing with space engineers is that weapons need more depth in the way they're modeled because they're so easy to exploit now. Those 100mm missiles, they're balanced in relation to the vanilla ones. But because of the whole deformation thing and because of how the game works, they end up being more effective. You can just spam them.
Now, if you want a weapon of really mass derpiness that is scary as hell and I'll never build on a server because it's not practical at all, just something I built for just to test out of how rotors work.
Oh yeah, you got the thing in here. I'm showing my freaking my flint head.
Oh, what the hell?
Cockpit.
Whoa.
Yeah, it's gonna cause lag. Holy crap.
Stonehenge.
Oh, the lag.
Yeah, so like that, with modded weapons from a long range, if I could get longer range out of them.
Speaking of the 100 mil, here's my
yourself out.
Yeah.
Cat fires too fast, that's your problem.
Yeah.
Cat fire short burst. Pull down the rate of fire. I can tell when you miss.
Mm-hmm.
I can tell when you hit too. The problem with that chip is it's got too high a rate of fire that the explosions will actually travel back up the stream.
At the same time, you need a strafe and all that shit too. Make sure your shots are scattered so they don't do that.
Yeah.
That's cool.
This poor Hyperion has seen better days. I have to build a better one now. Got one more JD ship I've been refitting lately. Here, I'll get rid of this and I'll spawn it in.
Okay, check it out.
I'm not sure I'm happy with it, but you might remember this one. It's one of JD's old destroyers. I mean, we're going back here. But...
Oh, the original Cerberus?
Yeah.
Yeah, the one that is more like a Pillar of Autumn looking.
basically just gutted the interior and redid the whole thing. But I want to do the new welder thing I came up with just because I think it'd work better. But,
she's ugly as fuck, but looks like she could have fucking inflicted some serious wounds.
Yeah.
Yep, doors up here by between the front thrusters.
Oh.
I added height.
In a way, in space engineers, like compact ships like this make more sense. It's like what we say when they're too long, like your face is doing something and your ass is doing something else.
Yeah, I got that thing set up with if it gets depressurized, it closes compartments off as it goes.
Nice.
Got the forward bridge down here, main engineering, medical bay is underneath the back here. Bridge up forward.
Yeah, this is a really practical ship. I mean, the new Cerberus is based off the Stalwart class frigate from Halo, but I think it's just too big, too long, and
a lot of empty space.
Yeah, it has too much of one thing all around the ship, so I mean it ends up lacking. For example, having only just one jump drive, things like that.
One's got two, I think.
Yeah, like a lot, like it could be repiped and all that. It's like, mm-hmm. Every time I look at it.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, this one's repiped. I mean, I've got pipes running along, I think, the sides or top and bottom, I think.
Like this thing right here looks like it could jump in somewhere and fuck everything up in the vicinity and jump back out. I was like,
yeah. Yeah.
The only thing I'm not happy with is the welder placement on the turrets. I might, instead of doing them recessed like that, I might do them where they're flat, because it'll make things airtighter, a little simpler. But
BRB, gotta go check on my meat.
Okay.
And it doesn't have a decoy system, so I'm not happy with that. But I didn't know how to incorporate one without changing the design radically.
Yeah, you would have to elongate it a little.
I did have a point defense system, so that was my compromise. Got all the little interior turrets everywhere. So that gives the ship a little bit better survivability if they can shoot missiles down.
Yeah. Yeah, no, these definitely have way better turret coverage, and I like
On the ventral section and dorsal sections, there were no turrets, so I added turrets. I also added turrets on the back mounts he didn't have, so.
Makes sense.
Now with the decoy system, I might do something like a hammerhead front end on it or something with decoys, but absorb the impact or.
Yeah. You know, I eventually just decided to not do the whole front camera thing, because I discovered that no matter how deep I bury that thing, it would always get snapped off.
Lasts as long as the launcher's along with it. So after if it all gets taken out at once, who cares? So
true. I mean, kind of like what I did with the Calypso, the one that I have over there, is that I split it in two halves, and I have the cameras on the sides.
That's what I did with the gunboat I built. I had cameras up top and bottom, recessed back behind the launchers.
So what idea?
This was a challenge. I mean.
Mm-hmm.
I basically rebuilt the entire outer shell from scratch and went from there.
For this Cerberus?
Yeah, I rebuilt the outer shell, worked my way back in.
Nice.
Redid the entire armored box, so you got the light armor on the outside, then you got the armored box on the inside.
Yeah. What's the mass on this one?
No idea, I haven't looked at it. Let's find out.
Yeah.
Is what 3.6 million kilograms?
Which wow. No, actually, that's
triangle count gets a little high for my liking, but for large ships, I try to keep 300,000. But
well, I think for a destroyer, is fine. Let me check. I'm gonna see how it handles.
I added the hydrogen thrusters top and bottom for maneuvering, so you can turn a little better. But braking is the weakest point on this entire ship has got to be the braking thrusters. There's only two of them, which is a very big liability. But.
Yeah. Well, to be fair, I just do a turn and burn.
Yeah.
I'm not that big on braking thrust.
Primary engines, you've also got the ions, plus you got the hydrogens for when you need to get up and go, so. How's the maneuvering handle?
I'm so used to having like a lot of gyros that it feels a bit slow for my taste, but
you can find a way to cram more gyros in it.
I mean, it's more of like the way we make ships, like Sokun and Seth and me. So I'm not saying that it's bad or anything. It's just
like those highly maneuverable ships.
Yeah.
That's one thing I've been talking about with a few people is like, see, like, yeah, gyros are nice, but there should be like a diminishing returns. You know, at some point when you get so many gyros, it should be like, okay, that's it.
Yeah, there's gotta be a way of balancing those things somehow. So basically, you can actually have like more defined classes of ships. Though I don't know if it would be a good thing. I don't know if like people would like that. Because you know the game is free, but I do agree in which like there's gotta be like some built-in mechanic in which you exchange one thing for the other, and that adds a building dynamic to the game. So okay,
I was thinking computer core for like the ship, like a central block you build everything off of. Like here's your primary core. It'll limit you with depending on how much resources you put into upgrading it, how many turrets, how many engines, and all that stuff you can have on it.
Like Eve or. Starmate, is it?
Yeah, maybe. Like, you know that like new hacking block they got? Like, have a central computer on the ship. Your computer can handle so many turrets. If you want more turrets, you have to upgrade the computer.
Yeah, I mean, that's not a bad idea.
Because then you could build, like, hacking devices to take over a ship, and, okay, you're going to need to dump this much computer components into it to hack the ship if you want to take it over. Or it'll take you this long with what you're using to take the ship over. Like if you capture a ship, hey, we want to, we just captured this base, we want to convert everything to us. Okay, it's going to take you this many components, and the more components you add, the faster it hacks.
Yeah. I mean, there's a dynamic in place like that for power and thrust. That's fine. But, yeah, something like that for weapons. I say it's needed because it just gets so crazy, so fast, so out of hand. And then you have like the issues. Okay, I have a server, and then I don't have any, built-in rules for it. So people start building like stupid stuff, like something with, let's say, 50 drills, and then it messes up the game for all of the rest of the players.
Yeah. So something that'll limit your amount of utilities you can use, the amount of refineries you can use. So if you want more, you have to upgrade and you have to pay for it.
Yeah. I mean, it's nice, like what Seth was saying, he actually showed me the whole discussion in the forums about SESE being integrated eventually into the game. That's amazing. Yeah, now, as a server manager, you can set that. But it would be nice to have it as an in-game mechanic.
Yeah. That'd be the smart way of doing it, just making it an in-game mechanic where administrator can modify it if they want for their particular server.
Yeah.
This is some of the best damn jerky I've ever had.
Yeah, that sounds tasty. But definitely, I mean, it's the game does definitely have some, it does have some mechanics in place.
It needs a few more, but it's, progress.
Hit it with the nuke.
Yeah, if you want to, go ahead. Yeah, it holds up.
Yeah. It will be interesting to see.
I've never fired anything at this thing yet. I've just built it for the most part. It's pretty much done, I think, except for the self-repair system. I haven't finished it on it, but or I haven't got it set up yet. See, there's three hydrogen tanks in the back. There's one midships just for the central thrusters, just in case the back gets nailed. But
how many do you have in total?
Coming in.
I got four, I think, on board. I know I should be using hydrogen a lot more, but...
Yeah, I was going to be... 4 hydrogen tanks.
I'm never going to hit this fast or hard. I'm just going to hit it.
Look pretty from this side.
Huh.
Wow. You breached... You were like 3 layers at light armor plus the heavy there. Jesus.
I was going only 40... 40...
Wow, that was devastating as hell. Breach the CIC. Now gravity's still there, so that's good. Something. Yeah, breach the CIC. Forward bridge is still intact. I've got massive hull breach. Yeah, you went. You took out like 3-4 decks right there in one shot. Powerful ass weapon.
So yeah, definitely like ships that are fatter and that are moving take the most. Because I mean, now I get it. If the ship is wider or thicker, more blocks are being affected by the same explosion. If the ship is thinner, oh, holy.
Okay, that was a nice front row view.
Yeah.
Okay, that went right through the other side, but it's pretty intact.
Try yeah. And I got freaking stopped to a dead... I went to a dead stop because of sim speed and shit stopped me.
Yeah, we're starting to lag. Let me do some cleanup. You know, that's also another reason why it's a first strike weapon, because, you know, the whole taxing on the server... After a while, you cannot use it. Like, it just becomes ineffective.
You're hitting yourself more.
What am I doing? Okay.
Here, when you fire another one at it, aim for the rear section. I want to see what it does to engineering.
I'm gonna get away.
That seems like 2 layers of light armor with a heavy armored core is basically what most of the ship has. I don't think you'd get past the weapon system if they were turned on. But
mm-hmm. Yeah. That's your thing, the whole delivery.
Now, if you can get the ship's weapons focusing on another ship that's attacking it, and then fire everything at it, yeah, you got this thing.
I think, ideally, what you would like to do with this, it's a formation of drones. The missile would be in the center, and then the decoys would be on the sides, a bit forwards.
Well, with decoys now targeting stuff, what you could do is have 2 pistons go out with decoys on it, put your ship in a spin. Now all the weapons fire is going to be shooting at the decoys because it spirals at the target and then corks burn into it and you'll hit every time. That was an old thing Ravik used to do on some of his torpedoes. He had them where little rotors would pop out with 2 decoys on it and it would draw the fire away from the warhead.
The first player that I saw do that was Mark 84?
Yep. Yeah. Coming in.
Okay.
1.5. Let's see if I get freaking halted this time again. 3. One click out. 45 meters per second. We hit the dead engines dead on. 50. 300 meters out. 60.
Oh wow, right up her tailpipe. Oh wow. Took out 2 of the rear hydrogen tanks, totally annihilated a jump drive. Massive hull breach. Reduced her reactor capabilities. Do I still have the second jump drive down there? I want to make sure. Yeah, I still got 1 jump drive, so. Not totally. This would be like a okay time to retreat idea.
Yeah.
If I took. But okay, we just got a hole blown in our ass. Actually, the weapons and conveyor system is still operational, but I could, I'd still be combat capable here, but I'd want to really guard my backside.
Yeah, I mean, you'll be on the defensive. You wouldn't be able to chase.
I could still chase, but I wouldn't be as fast as I'd be, normally be, because I'd be lost my three main hydrogen thrusters. But
wait, you don't have a grab drive, right?
No, this is just hydrogen for it. So I've started moving away from grab drive on larger ships because you don't really need it.
Yeah.
Not hydrogen. So.
Yeah, that's true.
And on small ships, it's nice because hydrogen's big and bulky, so you can still cram a grab drive in the same spot you would cram a hydrogen tank. So. Yeah, that would seriously cripple the ship right there. Boy, I think you'd have a hard time getting past the four Gatling turrets lading your ass up there. And again, you never know. If you want to kill both jump drives, come in here on an angle, hit right behind one of these thrusters. That would probably do it. Here, I'll spawn a new one in. And this should even have two pistons on it.
Give me a second, let me modify this real fast.
Alright.
I'm going back to my previous. The only problem with the old configuration didn't have the stacks that I have them now.
What's the optimal stacks number for the explosives?
500, sets of 500.
Best edition survival, or?
Yeah. You'll send, like, it completely wiped the freaking base off the map. Like, the outside, the exterior, like, it left a huge gaping hole. And the interior of the fucking thing was just deleted. Like, it was, they had a box-shaped fucking, base. Turrets all around. I hit it from the top. And, yeah, long story short, yeah, nothing was left of their fucking base.
Did a piston just explode?
We're on my ship?
Yes.
Maybe?
Two pistons exploded.
Okay. Yeah, I need to get rid of those docking pistons. Well, that's devastating. Does more. Here, let me get a new one. I don't know why they did that.
Oh, I hate those things. Just, I would never use them, even after they're fixed.
What?
Pistons and rotors. I mean, it's.
Rotors I'll use because as long as you're not using them constantly, they're fine, but pistons are just dangerous as hell.
For me, they're still unnecessary evil, rotors. Because you can get. For example, here's the thing, the program block, the thing's right. Gigantic. And then the small grid one does the exact same thing. And it's super tiny, like the size of a laptop or something like that.
Yeah.
That bothers me. So, hell, if I do the whole rotor tricking thing, I can actually have a computer core in my ship.
Yeah.
And I'll have to create like an entire compartment or an entire deck just for, you know, running three scripts.
You just need to make a block that'll go from large to small so you can do stuff like that. So you can build your computer core. Because then what you could do is, like we were talking earlier about having like a module on your ship for like guns and stuff, you could build the module and then add as many modules onto it as you want.
Yep.
So like for each one, you need a fire control module for every turret. Okay, if you got 10 turrets, you need 10 fire control modules. Throw them on there. For every so many thrusters, you need a thruster control module. All
right, I'm going to try this thing out, see if it works.
You know, like, yeah, that would be interesting, because then you will have to design ships also, you know, keeping in mind that you have to protect those.
Yep, because then if your module gets out, your turret effectiveness drops down.
Ooh, no piston, and I'm so fucking fast and maneuverable. This is nice.
You feel free.
It's gonna explode right beforehand, but it's bam.
Oh,
oh, it didn't work.
It bounced. Did that drive you?
We can try hitting it flat on instead of at an angle.
Your sloped armor is your weakness.
Mm-hmm.
Got explosives scattered amongst the ship, so.
Okay. Sorry about that. My headset powered off. That was funny. Let's see.
Coming in.
Did that work?
Yeah, it did some damage.
Oh. It's like a can opener. I see a projector. Oh! What the hell was that? You impacted it.
Yep.
Wait a
okay.
second.
You didn't do as much damage as you did last time.
Yeah. What did you say you changed, Laser?
I took the piston off and did the premature detonation one.
Oh, don't do that one.
Okay, my ship's still active, but you reduced its braking thrust. Okay.
So I think like having the piston as a penetrator tip and then having the whole explosion internally, it actually makes a difference, a huge difference.
If you get your explosion to go off inside the ship, that's a hell of a coup right there, because you start doing more damage.
Yeah.
The outward explosive force, I mean, like even with a regular standard torpedo, if you can get with a warhead on it, if you can get that warhead to breach the ship and then detonate.
So in other words, you want me to explode inside of you?
Yeah.
That's the general idea.
Pretty much.
Coming in.
That's how you get girls pregnant and blow up ships.
Yeah, that's the only way you're going to keep the species going.
What the fuck? I just got stopped. Thanks, game.
Let some whiplash and torpedoes on this thing and see how it operates. But
actually, I got an idea.
I've been having trouble with Whiplash's missile script. I don't know if I'm using it right, but
trying to get into coming here, but I don't know. He's being AFK.
Okay. My gyro's down though, so I can aim better.
Need some trash removal.
Okay. Lined up on target. Fire one. Fire two. Fire three. Fire four.
Yeah, we have reached the quota for the game. I'm gonna have to restart the world because collisions are being like meh. I'm not gonna do anything.
Hold on, let me hit it first.
Those weren't going that fast.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, they were easily using small thrusters. I built those torpedoes poorly. That's the kind of thing you need like 1,000 kilometers to get a hit in. I mean, it did the damage I expected it would.
I think trash removal is not doing what it's supposed to.
I think I fixed the issue with the thrusters, with the pistons. Okay. I had to put thrusters on the front and override them.
Oh. Ah. Oh. Yeah.
Yeah, broke the game.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, definitely we were at the threshold. That was the last drop. I'll get it up and running again.
Yeah, I'm gonna do a rebuild of the Hyperion. I've learned a few things since I've built it last. So, I mean, hell, I posted that thing in December. Jeez.
Yeah, it's due.
It was an old one the Soda Society used. They added a primitive decoy system on the front of it, and I took what they had and upgraded it. Probably going to try to put some hydrogen on it too, get some tanks on there.
I think you've done a really, really great job with making those ships survival usable.
I mean, the Hyperion was survival usable before, but it wasn't as effective.
Yeah, I don't know. But like, whatever, anything that I say now about what the matter is gonna make me sound like a jerk, but it's, if you take those ships, they may be piped up. That doesn't mean that they're gonna be, you know, play out well in a survival environment.
Oh yeah, but just like you only got one main feed for like a set. You're going down your hull. I mean, that's gonna be bad.
Really, that they don't have enough freaking hydrogen tanks. They have one tank for freaking.
Oh, you're little.
Don't get me started on that thing. That bothers me to hell. Like people who make, like let's say, I don't know, let's be conservative, like 5 large hydrogen thrusters, only one tank.
I mean, unless you're doing that as like a tactical thruster system. That's fine, but if you're using that as your main propulsion system, yeah, you aren't going very far.
Yeah.
Or you're not doing very many maneuvers. It's like, hey, I'm going here, I'm going there, I'm doing a few turns, and that's about it. But I mean, someone that's only got one tank like that, you're doing a slow speed battle. That's all you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I'll be right back.
Okay. Okay, the world is up. Actually going to
dude is doing a little wiry thing with the fibers, muscle fibers.
Oh.
Looks like little hairs and shit. That's some good jerky. Apparently, if you cook beef wrong and all that, like, you can poison yourself, too.
If you cook it wrong?
Mm-hmm.
Wait a second. Can you make it toxic by cooking it wrong? Because my understanding was that when it starts to decompose up to a point, you know, when it breaks down up to a point, is when it becomes toxic to humans.
Mm-hmm. It's like it's when it's almost like fucking charcoal.
Yeah. I get it.
And so it's like it's you cook like it's if you cook it and if you're baking it and you're jerking it at the same time, I guess it's it causes a chemical reaction in the meat. It's similar to freaking charcoal in that regards. If you eat too much of it, you get sick from it.
So many blueprints. Wait, did they? They made it so they are. Oh yeah. They're alphabetical now.
What?
The blueprints? Yeah, the blueprints.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't know that.
It's always been like that.
No, it was organized by the date that you. Well, I mean, at least the ones from the workshop. Oh, okay, those are still chronological.
From the workshop, yes.
Yeah, I mean the ones from your own are alphabetical, and the ones from the workshop are chronological. Okay, I wonder what we should try next.
Okay, I'm back.
Welcome back. I'm trying to think what to try next.
Jaren Dunne, he's just a boy. Poor little fella.
See if I can rebuild this old PvP ship. Joke by today's standards, but like, yeah. I like having classic stuff just, you know, to show this is how far we've come.
Yeah. Yeah, I still have like the first version of my destroyer.
The first version of the red ship.
I did a pretty good upgrade on that one myself.
You know, I think I never tried modifying the Red Ship or any of Keen's designs.
I pushed it as far as it could go, as far as I'm concerned, without radically altering the design. That's the first stage. Second stage is where? I'm building this from the old school blueprints we used to use before there were blueprints. If you remember that at all.
Yeah.
We didn't use blueprints, we just used stuff we found. No, I could take pictures and you do different colored blocks for everything. So people would know what it was you were building.
The earliest that I remember is when doors were client-based.
Yeah. I remember that. That goes way back.
Doors are client-based?
Yes. You open a door and close it, or you just open the door and went through, the person behind you would see it closed, and he would have to open the door in his client.
That sounds like pure cancer.
It was the early dark ages of space.
Yeah.
Okay, and then there's the next step, which is where? This ship is an antique by today's standards. We saw someone bring this into battle today, we'd all laugh at them.
Full heavy armor.
Yep, but I guarantee this thing is still effective. Maybe not as effective as other ships we've seen, but...
What does it do?
There'd be four Gatling turrets on it. This was like one of the first PvP ships I ever came across when I was on a server. All the tadpole. Camera on the forward section.
So you found it, or you made it?
Oh, I found this. I'm just making it from old school blueprints.
I wonder who made this.
This was the first one made by the UESC. One of their designs. That's basically all there is to it. Nothing fancy or to write home about, but it was the first ship.
I was just gonna say that it's funny how you can even make like a museum in this game, and you would actually see a progression.
First PvP ship I ever used.
Tadpole did evolve right now.
And the Nemesis was the first one I ever used.
It's one hell of a digi evolution.
Yeah. Actually, I think the Tadpole's got the better weapons placement for its age, but.
Mm-hmm.
For the Tadpole, I would have moved the. If I were to do a Tadpole today, I'd move the thrusters back, have the turrets forward.
Huh. And there was this decal on the large thrusters, the double squares, symmetrical squares on the bottom.
You got a logo on it?
No, on this little pattern, little texture.
One thing to note is that this is before thruster nerf, right?
Yeah, this is all before thruster nerf. Right now, these ships suck. I did do an upgrade to the Nemesis. Which I'm not happy with. But.
I mean, I like the Nemesis. I guess you could get away with it being, like, hydrogen-powered?
Yeah. Like, I did do an upgrade for it, but it's not as... It's got a few more bells and whistles than the previous one, but I'm not happy with some of the turret placement. I wouldn't do this again. But.
Yeah, turret placement, like, inline turrets.
Yeah, it's a horrible idea. You want them staggered.
Where the fuck is it?
But it's got a lot more survivability than the previous one, so. So that little forward bump out screws up the forward turrets, so. It does have a camera system on the front and back that are a lot more protected. Got a med bay too, so there's a plus.
I mean, it's definitely more usable.
Let's have some fun here. Let's see if we can redesign the tadpole and make it better.
Yeah, I mean, let's do that. Just basically what we're doing. Just foam building.
See, we're going to keep some of the basic concepts they have on board, just because we like those. Not really, but what the hell.
Pack these up for later. What are you thinking about, Jerky? You really have to worry about the squabbling. We're singing in a freaking...
Don't worry about you. Okay, I'm gonna do that.
This thing looks sick.
Alright. So I'm gonna make the front a little wider. So I can do a shield guard for turrets. Alright, that way turrets will give some protection. Of course, we didn't have these blocks when we first built these ships, so. Oh well. We do now, so that's all that matters.
My next project, next time I know somebody's doing smoking meat or whatever, fucking we're gonna try to smoke some jerky with them.
You have a smoker?
No, I know people who do.
I have one. I won it at a gun show.
Nice.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, here's a smoker I'm never going to use.
We want one. We want one, but yes, we're not sure about like what size.
Yeah, that's always the difficulty, is how big do you want it?
Mm-hmm.
Other than an apartment, we're not allowed to have that shit.
Yeah, that's your thing. No, but we definitely want one.
My roommate's too much of a goody two shoes, even though he's a fucking twat himself. You can't have that in here. It's like, yeah, you're not supposed to smoke inside the building either, but you do that anyways.
Yeah.
Whoa, that fucking lag. Shit. I haven't seen Gyro lately. He's been playing a lot of War Thunder.
Yeah.
No, Gyro has no time for us no more. But he did get that job.
Yeah, exactly. And also, to be fair, Space Engineers has been, like, really, really messed up lately with multiplayer. And he's more of a survival player. So.
Yeah, so same here, like, fuck. I want to play, but same time, it's like, I have to get on. Like, right now, I want to make a fucking base, like a stationary base, fucking in the asteroid field, but it's so laggy. Fucking, I get started on it, then. Because of lag and shit, I don't get to the beacon in time, and I end up fucking losing my progress.
Huh.
It's like, fuck, really?
Yeah.
If I had to rebuild the design, I'd probably do it like this.
Yeah, that? I get flung into the asteroid, fuck.
I mean, this thing's going to be underpowered with the number of thrusters it's got, but that would have a lot better survivability than the old version.
You know, Seth should see this. Maybe he could do something similar or like borrow the design for for one of the pirate ships.
Like a drone bow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, make it more out of light armor except for the front end, but.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't like the front though, because if you think you lose the thruster, then you're reduced your navigational capability.
Mm-hmm. Well, if it's using whip script, it could do the whole like peel off maneuver.
I was gonna do it on the cheap. Whoop.
Oh.
What the fuck happened?
Cockpit going and breaking loose. So. If you want to do it on the cheap, what you do is, let's build a new one. If we want to do it on the cheap, we're going to let's build a small gunboat. What the hell? Why not?
Mm-hmm.
You got a decoy there. Gonna armor the front up. Let's go. Run up.
After this, actually, I'm gonna do something. I'm gonna split the stream here.
Alright.
And we'll do this, and then a project that I wanna have some input on.
Alright.
So give me 1 second.
Fuck is. Ooh, this looks neat.